Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Rocky Road nut clusters. And this is a confection that I think you'll enjoy. It's very easy to make, tastes really good. Let's come over here and I'll show you what I've already started. I have a package, or I did have a package of chocolate chips. These are baking chips. They are semi-sweet chocolate. It's a 12-ounce size package, but you notice it's empty because all of it went into the top of my double boiler. You can see the boiling water below. You don't want this sitting in the water. It should be above the water, and the steam from the water will melt the chocolate. And it is completely melted. I got started a little early on this to show you what the result would be. And I'm going to turn this off because the next step here is to cool it down. Now, another thing I did over here at the stove was I took almonds, and these are slivered almonds. There aren't many left here, so it doesn't really matter what kind of package you have. You need this much, 1/2 cup. And what you need to do is to toast them. And I already have these toasted. I put just a very small amount of butter, just enough to make these glisten. And then I turned on this burner and I stirred occasionally. And you want to stop the cooking when it is a little less brown than what you're seeing here, because it quickly browns up and can go black instantly. You can burn almonds very easily. So what you want to do is toast 1/2 cup of slivered almonds. If you prefer sliced almonds, that's okay. They have that peeling on them, that hull, I guess, husk or something. You might not like that in your candy, so I'm choosing the slivered almonds. And you can use something that's a bigger size than this if you want, but I think this is a nice compromise. So 1/2 cup toasted almonds, and then 12 ounces of melted chocolate. We need to let them both cool, and then we'll come back and assemble our Rocky Road nut clusters. We're ready to continue on our Rocky Road nut clusters. So I'm going to go over to the stove and get our melted semi-sweet chocolate. So that has been melted and cooled. I let it sit at room temperature for a while, and then I put it in the refrigerator for a while. It's a little hard to stir, but you don't want it to set up. You want to be able to stir it. But if you, as cool as you can get it with still being able to stir it, will be the best. And you notice I don't have any boiling water down there because we want it as cool as possible. And then I also have over here my toasted almonds, and I put them in the refrigerator just to have them nice and cool to go with this mixture. So remember, that was 1/2 cup of toasted slivered almonds. So we'll just put those in. They're kind of stuck. I'm gonna take the spoon and pry them loose. They have butter that is connecting them to the bottom of this little nonstick skillet. So there we go. And the final element that we put in are miniature marshmallows. Here I have just an example package. This is a craft brand. You can buy any brand that you like, but they should be the tiny ones. So you're going to put those in 1 cup. And then stir this around. And my goal is to get all of this completely blended without melting the marshmallows. That's why you have to cool your semi-sweet chocolate chips after you've melted them. You have to have them so that they will not melt the marshmallows. So they get cooled off before this mixture is put together. But it doesn't take long to get this combined. And once it's combined, what we will do, and I think we're ready right now, we will take a pan like this and line it with wax paper. You can use parchment paper if you prefer. This is just regular wax paper. And honestly, this will make more than one pan's worth, but I'm just doing this for demonstration purposes, and I'll show you what you need to do. When you have this mixed to your satisfaction, and like I said, it is a little hard to mix because that's toughened up a bit, but you're going to take a teaspoon, and it still has some of my almonds on it. Try to get those worked in. Take a teaspoon and get about a teaspoon's worth out and put that on your wax paper, just in a glob. Or a cluster might be a better word, since we're making Rocky Road nut clusters. And you just continue to get your teaspoonfuls and put them on the wax paper. And the next step will be that the pan goes in the refrigerator for 15 minutes so that they will set up. You need them to harden. After they're set up, then you can put them on a plate or whatever and serve them. If you want to store them long term, it's best to put them in a sealed container and keep them in your refrigerator. But I think you'll enjoy this recipe, and I'll come back and show you the end result. I actually put our Rocky Road nut clusters in the freezer for a while, probably 15 minutes or so, and you can see how easily they come off. You just put them on a plate to serve them like this. That makes a nice presentation. Once you have your Rocky Road nut clusters on your serving dish, you can just serve them and leave them sit at room temperature for quite some time. But if you're going to store them for long term, then you either cover that with plastic wrap or aluminum foil, or maybe an idea like this. If you have some kind of container that you have a seal for, a lid, then you can place some of these. Just imagine that I go ahead and fill that, and then I would put my lid on. I just put it in the refrigerator, and it will keep for days like that, and you can bring it out for one nut cluster, or you can bring it out when you want to entertain. So you can do this the day ahead or whatever, but it will store very well if you put it in a sealed container. I hope you enjoy the Rocky Road nut clusters.